FAU Stadium here in Boca Raton, Florida, opened in October of 2011, and the stadium just the first phase of the university's Innovation Village. And now we bring you the coin toss, and it's presented by Nissan, innovation that excites. Bell has the ball set, and he looks ready to kick this one deep to open up the ball game. Here we go, folks. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback. The quarterback brings his troops out onto the field for the first drive of the game. Nice run up the middle. Taken down at the 41-yard line.
The reason why it's so crucial to be able to run effectively like this is it keeps the defense guessing. They have no idea whether you're passing or running, even if you need medium to long-range yards.
Has some daylight.
And he's tackled after positive yardage. The stop, the 39-yard line. And that was an excellent run there.
Yeah, Brad, but it was also great blocking up front by the offensive line to open up the hole.
Gains his way to the 30-yard line. For a sack on the play. The safety comes up with a nice sack.
Yes, he does. Here he comes clean on the blitz and got to the quarterback before he had a chance to really go through his progression. Nice play for this defense.
Third down now, and they need to get it to the 29. Gets rid of it.
Even though they didn't sack him, the pressure was still enough to force a bad pass. If you can get in there and disrupt the pocket, then the quarterback is going to have a tougher time getting the ball to his playmakers.
Florida Atlantic is looking to go up by three. The kick is away. It's long enough. And he just drilled it from long range. Kicker looks like he's ready to kick this one off. Patton fields it at the two. And down he goes at the 28. So let's see what the offense can do as they come out onto the field. Side run there. It's second and six. Ball on their own 32. Going to try and scramble. And he's tackled at the 41. From their own 41-yard line. First down. Now he's scrambling. He's taken off. And down he goes around the 50-yard line. They spread the field in the gun with five wide receivers.
tries to buy some time.
Tackle made at about the 49. And they'll look to convert here on another third down. Try the left side. He gets out to about the 48-yard line. And he is drilled at the 47. We've got a second and nine here. Ball on the 47. Taken down at the 46. This is the ninth play of this drive. And he shoved out of bounds at the 40-yard line. It's fourth down, and they're going to try to go for it. Right away. And this is the 11th play of the current drive. Makes it out to about the 26.
That's how we do, D. That's how we do. They don't want none. They don't want none of this.
It's second down, and they're about the length of the football from the first down marker. Hits him hard at the 24-yard line. And this is the 13th play of this drive. Might have been some early movement up front.
You got to be careful to avoid these. Penalties are a great way to stall out a drive.
First and 15 now after the penalty. Bring him down around the 12-yard line. What a play.
Boy, solid job there by the quarterback, recognizing the defensive coverage and delivering the ball to the open receiver.
Here's play number 14 of this drive. Tailback brought down for a loss. Both offenses trying to find their rhythm in that first quarter. Low scoring and close right now. The Owls with a three-point lead. We can only hope the second quarter is as good as the first. Tight ball game, folks. They go with the run. Tackle at the 12-yard line. He gains a couple of yards on the carry.
We've watched this guy play, and over the course of his college career, he's made some spectacular tackles. Nice play.
From the 12-yard line, third down. Looks for the tight end, but they can't hook up. Texas El Paso is looking to tie things up. They try to get a head start there.
Sometimes what happens on a false start is a lineman will see movement on the other side of the ball and be coaxed into jumping early.
fourth and 15 after the penalty. It's up, and it splits the uprights. Bell has the ball set, and he looks ready to kick this one deep. He just drills this one. He's to the 20. At the 30. He's pushed out of bounds. At about the 41. Not a bad return.
This is the point in the game where you don't want to make any mistakes that give the other guys a reason to feel more confident going into halftime.
They come out in an empty backfield. He's on the run. And they push him out
around the 30-yard line.
They'll spread the field here. Let's see what the defense does with a five wide outlook. Slings it. He's tackled at the 21-yard line. Brought down at the 19. Taken down at the 16-yard line.
That's what I do.
Let's go, let's go. Here we got Mike, number 53. Mike, 53.
Makes the catch and gets out of bounds.
Good job here by the receiver to look the ball in and ensure he had possession. That's the right way to catch a pass.
Wrestle him down in the backfield. And the tailback goes nowhere on the option. They're at the 3. Second down. Let's see if they try to pound it in here. Both teams have their goal line sets on the field. Touchdown, Owls. For the score.
Yep, he punched that in from a short distance. He had great blocking up front on that play.
He makes the PAT. It was a 7-play, 41-yard drive. And the result, 7 points.
An amazing drive for this offense. Outstanding execution. If you're the defense, you've got to do something to try to change things up to get this quarterback out of sync.
And he got all of this one. Great kick. Tackle at the 21.
With one quarter down, I really haven't seen too much separation between these two squads. Might be neck and neck the whole way.
Makes it out to about the 30. Great job by the running back, and that's a gain of 9. Short yardage situation here. Second down and 1. He's brought down in the open field.
Too tight, too tight.
They'll run it. That's a great tackle at the 35.
The offensive line needs to do a better job of not only handling the defensive linemen, but getting up to the linebackers. That way the ball carriers will have a little bit more room to get to that second level.
From their own 35-yard line, it's second down. And he's hit before he can go anywhere. The stop
right around the 44-yard line.
That'll be a gain of 3 yards.
Tonight's play by the defense to shut down all the lanes, so this halfback wasn't able to make anything happen on that play.
Smith back deep to return.
drill. They're ready to start another drive, hoping to duplicate the results of the last one, which ended in a touchdown.
This quarterback right now is in a rhythm, and a lot of that has to do with his preparation. You can see right now with the reads that he's being able to make, getting the football out of his hands, that he's feeling very, very confident in his ability to throw the football against this defense.
You don't want to ever give your opponent a second chance, but that's exactly what they did by not making that interception.
Florida Atlantic is up 7. And he's hit immediately. Around the 37-yard line. First and 10, ball on the 37-yard line. Catches it, and that's all. They just took what the defense gave them on that play.
Yeah, you're right. That was a good job of getting that pass completed for positive yardage.
He darts it over the middle.
Excellent execution on one side of the ball that time. And it looks to me like the defense was in a little state of confusion. Let's see if they can pull themselves together.
He heaves it to the end zone. Oh, boy, almost intercepted. From the 27-yard line, second down. Throws this one out to the left. Touchdown saving tackle, but it leaves him on a first and goal. And the wideout gets a chance to show what he can do.
Oh, he sure does, and he doesn't disappoint either. Great athletic ability.
Florida Atlantic is up by a touchdown. Finds the tight end for a touchdown. Splits the uprights with the extra point. A nice 8-play, 80-yard drive, and that's good for a touchdown.
I think the big thing there, Brad, is that they were able to execute the passing game. When you can get big plays and great execution, obviously you're going to move the ball down the field.
The score now, 17-3. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. And here we go with the offense ready to get things going again. Scrambling around. And down he goes at the 29-yard line. And he couldn't manage to get out of bounds and stop the clock.
Well, let's see how that affects them here in this situation.
From their own 29-yard line. Second down. Gets it out to the wideout, and he's got the first. And he's level at the 38-yard line.
He is such a reliable target. You throw it anywhere near him, and this guy's going to get his hands on it and make a catch.
He sails it long, and he tackles him hard at the 24. What a great play.
This is the timing that we talked about in the pregame that they must have in order to be successful with their passing game. That time, the quarterback threw it to a spot, and his receiver was there to make a nice grab.
Slides down. The Miners using their third and final timeout. So they decide to bring the kicker out to try to get 3 points before the half ends. Kicks away, and he's got it. With only a few ticks left on the clock before halftime, I would expect they'll just squib kick this one. He sends this one deep. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback. Not much of a problem getting the ball in the end zone on their last drive as this quarterback just picked apart the defense.
Well, I think this defense has got to do something because right now the quarterback is in such a good rhythm that you've got to do something to try to get him out of it. I would suggest trying to bring more pressure. Try to come up with an exotic blitz look to try to get him on his heels as opposed to being the aggressor and attacking the defense.
We've played 30 minutes. Glad to have you with us on the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 Halftime Show presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. David Pollack and I here in the studio to break down everything that just happened in your game. Perhaps the most important statistic in any football game is turnover margin. I once had a wise coach tell me that the football was so important they named the game after it. Whatever that means. I think it means that you're not supposed to let it get away from you and give it to the other team. And so far, both of these offenses have done a great job of that.
No doubt. And most games are lost, not won. And it's because of the turnover differential. And you can look at the stats when you say that every single time. But, you know, both teams doing a good job taking care of it. Both offenses executing and still calling a game, still scoring points, still putting up good numbers, but at the same time taking care of the pigskin. And they better value that thing because, yeah, you give it away and bad things happen.
Just about set to start the second half. What are you looking for?
I'm looking to see which team has that decided schematical advantage.
And if they can find it, they'll blow holes three or four axe handles wide. Brad and Kirk will be there to call the second half.
And we welcome you back to the action here, just about set for the second half. It's fielded at the 2. He's to the 20. Gets to about the 24-yard line.
Every single time this offense has the ball, they're moving the football, but they're settling for field goals. And every time they settle for field goals, I've been watching the defense that they've been facing and watching how they run off the field to celebrate a job well done because they're not giving up touchdowns. That's a bad sign.
Play fake, looking to run. Slides down to the ground. And that was a nice pickup by the quarterback.
Brad, I think this guy's amazing. He has an uncanny ability to scramble, and it showed right there on that play.
We've got a first and 10. Ball on the 42-yard line. Throws incomplete, intended for his wideouts.
These receivers need to be ready because he's capable of really launching some passes. That one was just out of reach.
They go with a screen here, and the halfback's got it. He's knocked out of bounds around the 50-yard line. It's third down, and they're about 2 yards shy of the sticks. Tackled outside after a nice pickup. Catch there before he stepped out of bounds. First and 10, ball on the 30-yard line. So the coach challenges the call, and they're going to try to determine if the receiver made the catch inbounds. So the referee initially calls it a catch, but we'll have a chance to take a second look at it and determine if he really was inbounds when he caught the ball.
Well, the side judge was standing right there, so I'd be surprised if he missed that call.
So after some discussion, the call on the field stands. Made at the 20. From the 20-yard line. First down.
Watch nine. Watch nine. Watch the team. Watch the
He's taken down at the 17. Here's the eighth play of the series. They'll bring him down right around the 4-yard line. First down. Big opportunity to score here inside the 5. It's first down and goal. He's going to try and scramble. And he's going to run this one in. Touchdown. Tacks on the extra point. A 9-play, 77-yard drive, and it's good for 7 points. So our score, 17-13. Everyone's all lined up and ready for the kickoff. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. It's going to be interesting to see how the action shakes out in this series. Florida Atlantic is up by 4. Decent run up the gut. Tackle at about the 35. It to the 44. And he makes it out to about the 44-yard line. Shoved out of bounds at the 49.
Man left, man left. Two down. Check 15.
And now he's going to improvise. And he can't get away from the pressure. Lumpkin back to return it. Little too much leg into that punt. They'll bring it out to the 20. Pretty good looking touchdown drive the last time these guys were out there. He's hit and taken down. Fires quickly, and he's got his man. They gained 5 yards there.
I got to give credit to the receiver here for getting separation from the coverage and making a good catch on the play.
Second and 5 coming up here. Ball on the 25-yard line. He's scrambling. Brought down right around the 34. On the counter, and he's tackled after positive yardage. From their own 38-yard line, it's second down. They go, they run, and he's tackled in the backfield for a loss. A little short toss across the middle. They'll knock him down for a loss. Peterson is the punter. He gets it away, and this is a really nice punt. He fields it at the 17. He's tackled at the 21-yard line. They were forced to punt the ball away the last time they had it. They'll be looking for a little more out of their offense on this possession. Florida Atlantic holds a 4-point lead. Gains his way to the 30-yard line. A great game so far, and it looks like it'll be decided in the fourth. The Owls lead it by 4. Welcome back to the action here as we resume play here in quarter number 4. To the 40. He's at midfield. And they finally push him out at the 42-yard line. Pulls it out at all. He's hit hard for a loss. That's a 2-yard loss.
They really just didn't have any room to work on that play. The defense just suffocated him there.
From the 44-yard line, second down.
Let's go, let's go. And we got Mike, number 53. Mike, 53.
Ready.
Block 90. Block 90. Motion.
Catches it, and he's immediately tackled behind the line. Loss of 3.
Not much going on there. Those kind of plays will not work against this defense. You can be sure of that.
Third down, and they need to get it down to the 32.
Three down.
Check Mike 11.
Fires that quickly, incomplete. Florida Atlantic is up 4. They get this one off, and it's a beauty. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. This is a pretty crucial series right here. With things being so tight, your best players have to step it up on both sides of the ball. Grabs it and hammered right there. Second and 8 coming up here. Ball on the 22-yard line. Makes a catch, and he's got nowhere to go. Zips it to the back, and they make the stop at the 32. From their own 32-yard line, it's first down. And he's tackled around the 48-yard line.
Here we go.
He's on the run. He gets sacked on the play.
And the senior steps up and comes away with a crucial sack.
Yeah, this game is coming down to the wire, and I don't think the O-line could have given up a sack at a worse time.
So that sack sets them back a little bit now. They're looking at second and 13. Just under three to go in regulation. Now he's scrambling. And he's taken down at the 43-yard line. Stays in bounds to make a nice catch. From the 30-yard line, first down. He's tackled at the 20-yard line. And this is the ninth play of the current drive. They got to him before he could get back to the line.
Really good play here in run support by the linebacker. The big guys up front took away the running lanes, and he was able to get through for a loss.
So it's third down, and they've got about 2 yards to go. Frustration by that offense, but you've got to give the defense credit for coming up with a stop in this quarter in a game this close. He's looking for his man, makes the catch and gets out of bounds. Well, this is it. They've got all four downs to get in the end zone. Just over a minute left. And he's level at the 2-yard line. Play 13 of the current drive. Got to be careful of a pass play with this defense. Somebody jumped early down there.
Little stumbles like these can kill your offensive progress.
From the 7-yard line, second down. Here's the halfback on the screen. Knocked out of bounds at the 1-yard line. And this is the 14th play of the drive. The short yardage defense here. Laterals back. Touchdown, and they take the lead. So the kicker will line up here and try to give his team a 3-point lead with this extra point. He makes the PAT. Texas El Paso to kick this one off. Nice kick, plenty of distance. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback. It's been a good one so far today. Let's see what happens here.
Do you take a shot at the end zone? There's not a lot of time left, but maybe they can catch the defense being overly conservative.
Things aren't tied, but they might as well be. It's this drive that could really dictate the tone for the last quarter. Throwing right. The defender had his hands on it, but it's incomplete. They're really fortunate that wasn't intercepted.
Not a very smart decision by the quarterback. He had no shot at completing it.
Second and 10.
Ball on their own 25.
Under a minute left in the game.
And down he goes, around the 42-yard line.
You know, talking with the offensive coordinator this week, he told us that he has a lot of confidence in his quarterback to make good decisions. And when he feels like he has an opportunity to put the ball up, he knows the receivers that he can count on to be able to make big plays. That's another example of that. Receiver goes up in the traffic and makes a big play for a first down.
Gonna hit the ground, incomplete.
The ball just sailed on him and he knows it. He'll get it next time.
It's second and 10. Ball on the 40. They'll spread the field here. Let's see what the defense does with a five wide outlook. Quick out to his receiver.
And he is drilled at the 18.
They'll line up with five wide receivers. He scrambled, decides to tuck it in, and he's got space. That tackle just sealed the deal. Really great game to watch. Both teams should be proud of their efforts in this one. 2017, Miners. That does it for this edition of NCAA Football 14. For Kirk Herbstreit, I'm Brad Nessler saying so long.